The Long Weeks Journalist Symposium, which has been taking place at Chamboko University, has today been closed by President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni. The symposium, which was under the theme Journalism for Socio-Economic Transformation, attracted journalists from as far as West Nile, Greater North, Western Region, Central Region, and countrywide. President Museveni officiated at the closing ceremony of this symposium. In his speech, the president mostly preached the gospel of prosperity to the journalists and advised them not to waste much time in talking, but rather tap into the so many government development programs like Emyoga and the parish development model to improve their earnings. He also tasked journalists to pass on the same message to the communities.
Message advised to you people is that in addition to education for all, we must get all the families to be involved in money economy, but with a chivaro, chura. Because if you don't work for money, you will not be prosperous. Aim number two, convince all your relatives to work for money, but with a chivaro. So that therefore means you must engage in wealth creation.
The journalists reported to the president the tough times they are operating, including peanut salaries, inhuman treatment by the security operatives, and overtaxation of their media houses by Uganda Revenue Authority.
Public knowledge that journalists are the mouthpiece, ears, and eyes of the society. Development is influenced by knowledge and information, which can be transmitted by journalists during the course of their duties. It's my humble appeal to the young journalists to always report objectively. We yearn for correct and accurate information. You recall that some societies have been affected or destroyed by false information or reporting. I invite fellow youth who are journalists to fight that cancer of corruption, false reporting, so that we take our country to greater heights.
President Museveni, in response, made a commitment to support the journalists by giving them grants through their circle groups. He encouraged them to form circles best in regions they come from.
I hear that the journalists want to have their circle. Oh, very good. I will support it. We shall go in the cabinet and sit and support those circles. Maybe, I think that maybe you can see by zone like Busoga, zone like Western Nile zone, because going to every district may be very tiresome, but like the zone, like Achori, Lango, zone, if they have their circle there, those are not many, there are 18 of them in the whole of Uganda, there are about 20. So if you form that, I would happily support it, put money there.
He, however, warned them against getting involved in public affairs they do not know. Instead, he advised them to put more effort in transforming the society. The Minister of Information, ICT and National Guidance, Dr. Chris Bariomunsi, encouraged journalists to stick to professionalism despite the poor pay.
We must appreciate we are reporting about our country. We don't report to damage our country. I have traveled a lot. I worked briefly in the U.S., in New York. I have been to many places. What many other countries outside do, they report what is positive and what promotes the image of their countries. And you may get an impression that America is like heaven. There are homeless people in America. I have gone to homes which have rats and fleas in America, but they will never show that on television. The security officer, the police, have a duty to do their work, but also you have a duty to do your work as journalists. We have met security agents and police, and I don't think those occurrences are now common, but we also agreed that we need to organize trainings for police to appreciate how to work with journalists, and also most importantly for you journalists, to know how to report and cover situations which are sometimes violent.
The president of Uganda Journalists Association, Matthias Rukundo, commended President Museveni for the liberalization of the media, which has seen the profession go from one media house, UBC, to so many media houses. He appealed to the president to financially come to the rescue of the journalists so that they can become financially empowered.
That if you can introduce a program that intends to give them financial empowerment, specifically for journalists, Your Excellency, we will be grateful to you, sir.
During the six-day symposium, journalists have been equipped with patriotism skills, being transformative, and sticking to ethical journalism, among others. Report compiled by Jaliat Namoya for the news.